Since the country's economy opened up to the rest of the world, a move that ultimately turned China into a global economic powerhouse, second in GDP only to the United States.
Tonight, the drumbeat of war.
This, of course, has got to do with the tensions in Asia.
We're over the South China Sea, and that is a Chinese fighter.
Competition between the world's superpowers is intensifying.
How close are we to all-out conflict?
You know, maybe one step closer to attacking Taiwan, staging massive military exercises miles off the Taiwanese coast.
The biggest threat we face as a country from a counterintelligence perspective is from the People's Republic of China, and especially the Chinese Communist Party. No country presents a broader, more severe threat to our ideas, our innovation, our economic security than China.
Hello, everyone. As we all know that in the 21st century, no force has seemed to be capable of halting China's incredible economic growth, which is propelled by a population of 1.4 billion people. And militarily, however, China lags far behind the world's sole superpower, that is the United States. But the question is that, will competition with the West drive China to global dominance? If so, then China will gain a status it has not had since the Ming Dynasty of the 16th century, when it was the world's prominent power. But before moving ahead, we need to understand what is actually superpower mean. So basically, a superpower is a country that dominates the world by militarily, culturally, politically, and economically, just like after the decline of the British Empire and other colonial states in the early 19th century. Germany and Japan briefly rose to the superpower status, but they were destroyed by wars. And just same as after the World War II, the Soviet Union and the United States rose to the superpower status as the two main protagonists of the Cold War. But the USSR collapsed in 1991, leaving a weak Russia and the ever more powerful US. But the United States status had several challenges, that are the emerging superpowers like China, India, and the Russia. While Russia's and India's status as emerging superpowers are debatable, but the China's role as the next dominant superpower seems to be real, because China's rapid military expansion and unceasing economic growth and its prioritizing of the retaking of Taiwan suggest that the US and its allies may soon come to blows with China and its allies. And there are several ways through which China exerts its power. Now we will be going to discuss one by one. Number one is China's economic power and its influence. China has undergone rapid economic expansion since 1979 and sustaining some of the fastest growth rates ever seen, with an average of 10% per year over several decades. Since the beginning of the open door policy in 1979, which introduced the country to foreign investments, and its GDP has grown from 178 billion to 14.72 trillion to make it the world's second largest economy, only after the United States. China's sole political actor, that is the Chinese Communist Party, CPC, steers all significant economic activity through centralized planning and five-year plans, while allowing capitalism and free enterprises to thrive. The CPC maintains a financial stake in foreign investments in the country while pursuing an aggressive export agenda, and China's low cost of labor means it is a favored location for international companies to locate, and its cheap goods have flooded in the world. At the same time, China's flourishing middle and upper classes forms the world's largest market for cars, smartphones, and other expensive goods. This means those companies which were located in China get increasingly wealthy by selling their products on the Chinese market. Number 2. Demographic factors. China's huge population and its economic chaos in the early years after the rise to power of the CPC in 1948 that leads to the one-child policy until 2016, then to the two-child policy until 2021, but these were backfired. Now there is a three-child policy. Eventually, China now has one of the fastest growing aging population in the world, with 28% of its population expected to be over 60 in 2040. In comparison, the equivalent statistics for India is 13%. Although demographic control policies have effectively ended, but it may be too late because as many projections shows, not only that the country will not be able to effectively afford or to take care of its elderly, but also that there will not be enough young people for the labor force. Number 3 is political factor. The CPC under Xi Jinping has tightened its grips on Chinese political activity and cultural expression, and since 2010 has evolved rapidly into a totalitarian surveillance state that tolerates no disagreement. This has led to crackdowns on minority ethnic groups such as the Uyghurs and Tibetans that Western observers claim are effectively case of genocide. Major capitalists and billionaires such as the CEO of principal corporations have often been jailed, such as Jack Ma. While the Great Firewall has made Chinese access to foreign media nearly impossible, the COVID-19 pandemic has led to the lockdowns, including the 60 million people in Hunan province, where the disease originated. Later lockdowns, such as that in Shanghai in 2022, demonstrated the formidable power of the CPC to completely control human activity. Number 4. Cultural influence. China's strict control of cultural expression has resulted in few cultural soft power exports. Instead, now China has become an importer of culture from countries that have freedom of expressions, particularly Japan, South Korea, and the United States. All these importers are either illegal and accessed through virtual private network VPN or heavily censored. For example, NBA basketball is very popular in China, but no anti-China pronouncements by the players or owners are permitted. And Hollywood movies which have all references to Taiwan as an independent country and numerous other sensitive topics are censored. Number 5. Access to natural resources. China sits on the top of large deposits of coal, oil, and natural gas, and its northwestern province, Xinjiang, is very rich in natural resources. That is why it forms a primary reason for the Uyghur population is tightly controlled because of historical moves by the Uyghurs to break from China. The CPC cannot allow this to happen as it cannot afford the resources that would be lost if the territory were lost. China is believed one of the world's largest producer and exporter of aluminium, gold, iron, magnesium, and other metals, including rare earth minerals. This is due to China's direct access to reserves in Africa, where in recent years they have gained mineral rights in many countries. China has also built an oil pipeline to Kazakhstan, and China's main strength in terms of resource access may be its growing alliance with Russia, with boundless reserve of minerals as well as timber and other products. Number 6. Military power. China has the world's largest army with 2.8 million active troops and has the highest military budget after the US, $237 billion. China's nuclear arsenal is also growing rapidly, just like its inventory of tanks, warships, planes, and aircraft carriers. China utilizes its military in many land and sea-based border disputes. Most recently, it has engaged in a standoff with several bloody clashes with India in the Himalayas. China's principal military goals are to secure its claims on land and sea borders or to retake Taiwan, which it considered a breakaway province and control of the South China Sea. China has been rapidly gaining military access to Pacific island nations and is increasingly confrontation not only with the US but also rearming Japan, UK and Australia. China claims that South China Sea belongs fully to China, and this has resulted in clashes with Philippines, Malaysia, Taiwan, Vietnam, Indonesia and Brunei. Although the core conflict are the exclusive economic zones around these areas, not just for fishing rights but also for the extraction of the natural resources. The South China Sea gives China access to the Strait of Malacca by Singapore, through which trade too much of the rest of the world moves. China cannot afford to lose control over the South China Sea. Number 7. China as emerging market. China's incredible economic growth has led to an enormous middle class of educated and prosperous consumers. According to official figures, its middle class population grew from 39 million in 2000 to 700 million in 2020. As China becomes more prosperous, its resource consumption increases rapidly. This is a good news for the economies of countries that export to China, although it also creates additional strains. For example, Brazil has boomed thanks to the Chinese demand for soybeans and iron, and the US has also benefited greatly from China's demand, and thereby foreign companies based in China such as Tesla not only take advantage of China's cheap cost of labor but also gain access to the lucrative Chinese consumer market. However, there are many negative sides also. For example, energy is needed to power all this growth, so coal and the pollution it brings is a major contaminant, and by relying on foreign sources for food and being unable to feed itself, and water consumption is also another problem in Beijing alone. Demand exceeds supply by 70% in 2012. That is why the control of Tibet is key in this respect, since the plateau is the birthplace of the Yangtze and other rivers upon which China relies, and other environmental stresses that China places on itself are deforestation, desertification, contamination of air, soil and water, destruction of wetlands and biodiversity loss. And China has recently become the largest CO2 emitter in the world, producing at least 27% of global emissions. While China has strived to lower its coal consumption and automobile emissions. Hereby, there are some key takeaways. As we have discussed, China is now really an emerging superpower, but whether it attains fully superpower status depends on several parameters, particularly the outcome of a potential war to retake Taiwan. And the major question is, will the China gain the same power as currently United States is enjoying? It remains to be seen. So that's all from our side. Please make sure to hit the like button, and for more such insightful case studies, please subscribe to our channel. Lastly, have a good day.